Good afternoon, students. Are you able to hear me? Am I audible, ma? Yes. Okay, fine. So we'll start the session now. Can anyone tell me what are the topics we covered in the last few GATE classes in TOC? Anyone? Yes. What are the topics we covered? So what is the first class we discussed was, we discussed about the regular expression and finite automata. And in the second class, what we discussed is context-free grammar is what we discussed. And in the third class, we discussed about what is the topic we discussed? Pushdown automata we discussed in the fourth class. What is the topic we discussed in the third session? Can anyone tell me? Anyone made a note of it? Yes? Yes or no? Okay. So we discussed about the pushdown automata, and now at last we are going to discuss about the Turing machine. Okay, so what is Turing machine? So I think some basics has been covered already. Yes, what do you understand by Turing machine? Okay. So it is a mathematical model, or we call it as a device that accepts the recursively enumerable set of languages and generally type zero grammars. So in the last class, we discussed about what is type zero, type one and type two, all those things. Yes. Yes. So Turing machine is a mathematical model, especially designed device that accepts the language which is of type zero grammar, especially this accepts the recursively enumerable sets. Okay, and a Turing machine consists of, so like how we discussed about the pushdown automata, we have an auxiliary stack, and we have an top of the stack denoted by a pointer called Z naught. How do we push the element and how do we pop the element, when to push and when to pop, so all those things. And pushdown automata, what is the advantages? If it is two different characters, we will be able to compare and we will be able to check whether that can be accepted by that pushdown automata or not. Yes, if it is more than two input strings, then we have to design a Turing machine for that. Yes, pushdown automata cannot compare more than two characters. So that's why we go for a Turing machine. Yes. So here, what is the storage we will be using? Yes, we'll be using a tape of infinite length. So which is mainly used to perform the read-write operations. Yes. So here, a Turing machine consists of a tape of infinite length on which read and write operations can be performed. Okay, so the tape, so we will have an diagrammatic representation in the next upcoming slides. So first we will go with the definition, and then we will see how the data are read or how it is written back into the tape, something like that. All those things will be discussed slowly one by one. So here the tape consists of infinite cells, so on which each cell either contains the input symbols or the special symbols called the blank. So we can have either input symbol or the blank. Okay, first I'll show you. Yes, look at this picture. You will have a better understanding of how the Turing machine uses a tape, something like that. Yes. So here this is a tape of, if you have a look at this diagram, left hand side, that is A1. So you have a closed structure in the left hand side, but I have a look at the right hand side. So it is not closed, which means the tape is of infinite length. So it keeps going as your input symbols in the strings keeps going. Okay, so here you will have, so you will have a tape of infinite cells. So each of this partition is what we call it as a cell. So where you can have only two possibilities. So the one is input symbol, or you can have a blank symbol. Okay, so mostly blank will be represented either by capital B or small b. So in the upcoming examples, whenever you see a symbol B, either small b or capital B, it is nothing but the blank symbol. Okay, so we have a finite control or a pointer, we call it as a pointer or register, that is used to move left and right depending upon the read write operation which we perform on the Turing machine. Okay ma, so this is the diagrammatic representation of the Turing machine. So you will have a tape, the tape is of infinite length. We perform read write operations on this tape. We can perform, you can insert only two symbols. The first one is can be an input symbol, and the second one you can have a blank B, blank symbol represented by the letter B. Okay, so the finite control is a register or a pointer, so however you want, you can just remember it is a pointer which can be moved left and right depending upon the input symbol what you read and depending upon the symbol that is present in the tape. Okay, so now we'll get back. And just check, this is what we discussed. A tape consists of infinite cells on which each cell either contains the input symbol or a special symbol called the blank. Okay, so it also consists of a head pointer which points to the cell currently being read, and it can move in both the directions. So this is what I told you right now. Okay. After reading an input symbol, it is replaced with another symbol. So whenever, so the task is, if an input is given, input string is given, you have to check whether the Turing machine accepts that or not. Yes, and same Turing machine can be performed to do the addition, subtraction, multiplication of two input numbers, so which we will be discussing in the upcoming examples. Okay, so what is the basic thing you have to do step by step? What are the steps you have to do is, whenever you read an input symbol, you have to, suppose if you are reading an input symbol 0, you have to replace it with another symbol, say X. Okay, and you have to change the state from, for example, if it is in the Q1 and where it is going, taking the input 0, where it is moving, whether it is moving back in the left hand side direction or whether it is moving to the next state in the right hand side. So the pointer can be used to move in both left and right direction depending upon the symbol present in the tape and depending upon the input which is read from the input string. Okay. Sorry. Okay. So after reading an input symbol, it is replaced with another symbol, its internal state is changed, and it moves from one cell either to the left or to the right. So this is the basic working of the Turing machine. So when we in the upcoming examples, when we solve the problems, you will be able to understand the exact working of the Turing machine. Okay, if the Turing machine reaches the final state, the input string is accepted, otherwise it is rejected. So this is same like all your finite automata and push down automata. If the Turing machine reaches the final state, so you can have n number of a set of finite states. Yes. So you can have even one final state, or you can even have a set of final states. So if the input string has reached any one of the final state, then that string will be accepted by the Turing machine. Okay, remember this point, ma. Okay. Okay, so this is the diagrammatic representation of Turing machine. We already discussed. We have an infinite length of tape. Each of this partition is what we call it as a cell. You can have possibly two things, input symbols or a blank represented by the letter B. Okay, so you will have a pointer to that moves left and right depending upon your read or write operation. Okay. Yes, so for sure you should know what are the difference. Why do we move from machine to machine? So when we have a finite automata, post-down automata, then why you need a Turing machine? So like this, you need a comparison. What is the purpose? We need all of these things. Yes. So finite automata, so we don't use any data structure like stack or tape or whatever is being used in the pushdown automata or Turing machine. Yes. So is it deterministic? Yes, of course. So finite automata can be used for the deterministic purpose where it does not use any of the data structures. Yes. And the next one is a pushdown automata. So what we discussed in the last classes, we have an what we call it as an storage. Auxiliary storage called stack, and stack is nothing but the last in first out. So whatever data you inserted at the last is the one that you can pop it out first. Yes, so you know the push and pop operation, which you have already learned in the data structure also. And at a time, you have to remember that only one symbol can be pushed or one symbol can be popped out of the stack from the top of the stack. In which the top of the stack is denoted by the Z0 pointer. So all those things we discussed when we were talking about the pushdown automata in the last class. Yes, and is it deterministic? No. So pushdown automata is not a deterministic one. So to overcome that, we went for the next upgraded machine, Turing machine. Okay, so what is the data structure we use in the Turing machine is what we have seen in the last slide. Yes. So we use an infinite tape consisting of an infinite cells. Okay, so where we use the input symbol and the blank symbol represented by the B. Yes, so we go for Turing machine, which is always deterministic one. So this is the comparison of the three machines or the automation machine which we have learnt. Okay, so coming to the notation and what are the important tuples that can be used? So a Turing machine is expressed as a 7-tuple. So we have 7 tuples, so represented by Q, T, B, Sigma, Delta, Q naught, comma F. So where Q is, as usual, it is a set of states, finite set of states. So you can have, for example, I can say we can have 4 set of states. Or you can have 5 set of states. So that includes all your initial states and the final states. Yes. So Q is nothing but a finite set of states. Okay. And T is a tape alphabet. So which is nothing but symbols which can be read or written on the tape. So T is nothing but the tape alphabets. Alphabets are the symbols that are written on the tape. And as I told earlier, you can have possibly only 2 symbols. So the first one, you can have the input symbol or you can have the blank symbol. So blank symbols are represented by the capital B. Okay. So initially, whenever a tape is allocated, whenever the memory is allocated for the tape, all the infinite cells will be represented with B, capital B. So whenever you try to write something into the tape, the B will be replaced with the input symbol what you want to write on the tape. Okay, ma? So that is what is told here. B is a blank symbol. Every cell is filled with B except the input alphabet initially. Okay. Okay, so sigma, as usual, we know it is the input alphabet. So symbols which are part of the input alphabet. So if it is 001, then that comes under your sigma, the 4th parameter. So the next parameter is a transition function delta. So which maps QT to the QT and L comma R. So depending on its present state and the present tape alphabet, so the pointer will decide whether it has to move to the new state or it has to reside in the same state. And depending on that, the tape symbol will also be changed. And the header pointer can move either to the left or to the right. So this is a very, very important function. So we call it as a transition function. So some state taking the input symbol and considering the tape symbol, where that tape pointer has to move, whether it has to retain in the same state or it has to move to the next state. So based on that, the state should also be updated. Yes, and the plus point is the pointer can move not only in the right hand side always, it can also move to the left hand side also. Okay, ma? Any doubts still here? Yes, okay. So Q naught, so we know already we have reached the end of the TOC session. So some basic notations you must remember. So you know already that Q naught is the initial state and F is the set of final states. So just have a look at the words, set of final states. So this is what I told. So in Turing machine, you can have any number of final states, not necessarily to be one always. Okay. So if any state F is reached, so in the set of states, if the input string or the tape has reached the end of the final state, then that input string is accepted by that Turing machine. Okay, ma? Any doubts? So till now we have discussed what is Turing machine, why we are going for the Turing machine, and what are the comparisons between the finite automata, pushdown automata and the Turing machine. And we have seen what is the data structure we use for the Turing machine. So we use a tape, infinite length tape, where the tape is divided into as cells. Each cells can hold the input symbol or a blank symbol. We have a transition states, and the Turing machine is expressed with the 7 tuple. So what are the 7 tuple is what we have discussed till now. Okay, ma? Okay. So adding points to the Turing machine. So here is what is given us, the time and the space complexity of a Turing machine. So for a Turing machine, the time complexity is nothing but the measure of number of times the tape moves when the machine is initialized for some input symbols, and the space complexity is number of cells of the tape written. So we know very well that, so I was keep on repeating, the tape is an infinite length tape. Yes, and I also told you that the tape can move either in the left or in the right side. So it can move either in the two directions. Yes, so the time complexity refers to the number of times the tape moves when the machine is initialized for some input symbols. And the space complexity is nothing but number of cells of the tape that is being written. So mathematically, notations, the notations used to represent both time complexity and the space complexity is given as follows. So T represents the time complexity and S represents the space complexity. So T of n equal to order of n log n, and the space complexity is denoted by S of n equal to order of n. Okay, ma? Okay, so let us construct a Turing machine for an example. So the language is given by 0 power n and O power n, where n is greater than or equal to 1. Okay, so if n takes the value 1, so your input string is going to be 0 1. If n takes the value 2, it is going to be 0 0 1 1. So what is the understanding you should get from this problem is it is going to be the number of zeros and number of ones is going to be the same. Yes, and the first input character of this given input string is always going to be 0. So 0, after which you are going to have the 1. So you can have equal number of zeros followed by equal number of ones. Only such language should be accepted by this Turing machine. Okay, so now let us follow a steps to construct a Turing machine to sort out this problem. Okay, so here we have 0 and 1. So possibly you will have only Q. So we know what is Q. So Q is a finite set of states. So possibly you can have 4 set of states. So Q0, Q1. So every time we start with the Q0, so Q0 first start symbol is nothing but the initial state. So Q0 is the initial state. And the tape alphabets are nothing but 0 and 1. And I told you already that initially everything will be blank. So we represent the blank with the capital B. Yes. And I told you that the methodology we use is whenever we read a character, so that input tape symbol should be replaced with another symbol. So here for 0 we use X and for 1 we use Y. Okay, ma? So you should know what is X and Y. So T is nothing but a tape alphabet. So initial string, so input string, whatever they give, it will be in the zeros and ones. Yes. So when we represent it in the tape, you can have blank symbol B. You will have the input string symbols zeros and ones, and it should be replaced. So whenever we read the tape alphabets with the tape reader or the register, so it should be replaced with another character. So here we are going to consider 0 is replaced with the X and 1 is going to be replaced with the Y. Okay, so sigma, the input alphabets as per the question given, is it is going to be either 0 or 1. Okay, ma? So F is nothing but a set of final state. So here possibly we can have only one state as our final state, so which is nothing but the Q3. Okay, ma? Okay. So the transition function is given as follows. So what it is? Q0, the initial state, taking the 0. So taking the 0 as input, what it does is it moves to the next state Q1 and the 0 is replaced with X. And it performs the write read operation and it moves to the right hand side. So that is the meaning of your Q0 taking 0. So you are initially in the Q0 state. So Q0, when it reads the tape symbol 0, what it does, I told you already. So when you read 0, it has to be replaced with the X and the tape pointer should move to the right side. So in the transition, we represent this movement as Q0 taking the input, reading the input symbol 0, it moves to Q1, X, R. Okay, ma? Any doubts? Shall I proceed? Yes? Okay. So next, look at the next row. So now we are in the Q1. Okay. So now Q1 taking 0. So already we visited 0. Yes. And already we have marked it as an X. Sorry. So already we have marked it as an X. So now you don't want to make any changes. So we just move to the next character right side. So that is represented by Q1, 0, R. So what if Q1 reads 1 instead of 0? Yes. So what you have to do is that 1, if different input string is read, then you have to move to the next state and replace the 1 with Y. And one more thing you have to do is you have to move the pointer to the left hand side. So I repeat, so two things has to be kept in the mind. So if you are reading the very first character, you just replace the character input string with either x or y. So if it is 0, you replace it with the x, or if it is 1, you replace it with the y, and you move to the right side. You move the pointer to the right side, which means you are ready to read the next tape symbol. Yes, suppose you are in a state, some state, say for example Q2, and you are reading the same input 000. So you don't need to move to the next state at all. You remain in the same state itself till you read a different input symbol. Okay, so now look at the third row. So now you are in the state Q2. Yes, so Q2, if you are reading 0, then you have to move again left. Yes, so suppose you are in the Q2 state and you are reading X. So now what you have to do is, already it is X and now also you are reading X, so you have to move to the right hand side. You have to move the pointer to the right. So suppose you are in the Q2. Yes, and you are reading Y. So what you have to do is, you have to move the pointer to the left side. Okay, ma? Yes? Yes or no? Yes? Okay, fine. So suppose you are in the Q0 state and you read Y. So what you do is, you have to move it to the right hand side and you move to the state Q3. Okay? So now you are in the state Q3. You are reading the input symbol Y. So you have to move it right, and whenever you find a blank, so during this transition process, whenever you reach blank, so what you have to do is, you have to halt. You have to halt the Turing machine. Yes, so this is the process or the procedure you have to follow whenever you are solving the Turing machine problem. Okay, so for better understanding, we will have 2 to 3 problems again. Okay, so where you can get all your doubts clarified. Okay, I'm just moving the slide as of now. Yes, we will discuss few more problems. So just hear that also, and at the end you try to come up with your doubts. Okay, ma? Okay. The same problem. So we'll take the input string as 0011 and check whether the Turing machine accepts this language or not, accepts this input string 0011. Yes. So initially the head points to 0, which is underlined, and state is Q0. So just look at this diagram, you will understand. So initially my tape looks like this. It is filled with the input symbol 0011, and we initially begin with the blank. Yes. So reading the input symbol 0, so what it does is, so look at the next diagram, you will understand. So the move will be, the transition is given as, transition is denoted by this symbol, yes, transition, delta symbol. Initially we are in the Q0 state, so Q0, taking the first input symbol 0, so whenever it is 0, you have to replace it with the X, and you have to update the state, which means you have to move from one state to the next state, and the tape has to move to the right hand side. So this is the meaning of this transition. So transition Q0, 0 is nothing but we move to the next new state, and 0 has to be substituted with X. And the pointer, the tape pointer has to move right hand side, which means it is ready to read the next symbol from the input tape. Okay, ma? So just look at the next figure. So it means it will go to the state Q1, replace 0 by X, and head will move to the right as. So from the first 0, we have replaced the 0 with the X, and the pointer has been pointing to the next 0, second 0 in my tape. Okay, so now what happens next? What happens next? Already we have read 0 and we have replaced it with the X. Again the same 0 is coming. So what you have to do, you have to remain in the same state. Q1 Q1ல இப்ப நீ இருக்க அப்ப Q1லயே தான் இருக்கணும் எத்தனை ஜீரோஸ் நீ ரீட் பண்ணாலும் யூ ஹேவ் டு ரிமைன் இன் த சேம் ஸ்டேட் Q1 அன்டில் த நெக்ஸ்ட் ஆர் த ஃபர்ஸ்ட் டிஃபரன்ஸ் சிம்பிள் அதாவது 1 எப்ப நீ ரீட் பண்றியோ அது வரைக்கும் யூ ஹேவ் டு ரிமைன் இன் த சேம் ஸ்டேட் Q1 ஸோ ஜஸ்ட் ஹாவ் அ லுக் அட் திஸ் வாட் வி ஹாவ் டன் இன் த நெக்ஸ்ட் ஒன் Yes, look at this. So Q1, previously we were in the state Q1. Already we have visited one zero and we have replaced it with the X. Again, you are reading the same zero. So what you have to do? Very simple. You remain in the same state. You don't want to change zero to X or something like that. Okay. What you have to do now? Again, you have to move and read the next. So right side, you move panite irukkanum. Eppa varaikkum? Till you find a different input symbol, adavadu 1. Now we are in the process of reading zeros. Yes, do you understand, ma? Okay, shall I proceed? Okay, so now we are in the process of reading the zeros. So 0 varavarekko ni adhe Q1 state le irundukittu tape mattu you have to move it to the right hand side. Okay, so this means so this transition Q1, 0 equal to Q1, 0, R, which means it will remain in the same state Q1, and without changing any symbol it will move to the right as shown in this figure. So now look at where the what is underlined. So now we have moved to the right hand side and now it is pointing to the tape symbol 1. So now let us check what happens. So we are now in the different symbol. Yes. So now what happens is we have read the first one. So what you have to do? We are in the state Q1. So you have read a different input 1. So what you have to do? Obviously, you have to move to the next state Q2. And 1 in the vanda, what I have told you, you have to replace it with the symbol Y. Okay. But the important thing is, you have to start moving your pointer left hand side. So look at this diagram. I take the previous diagram. Here you will have, just leave the blank. So just look at the input symbols. You will have X011. So ippa enna pananum inda 1 ku badhila Y nu maatite on pointer right la move panna koodadhu. You have to move it to the left hand side. So this is the step what is being shown in this diagram. Yes, this one has been replaced with Y and the pointer has been moved and pointing left hand side symbol. So which means 0 is being pointed. Yes, so as of now we have gone Q0 initial state, Q0 la irundhu Q1 ponu, Q1 la irundhu ipo Q2 ku poirkom. Okay, ma? Yes? Okay. So now just see what happens next. Okay. So working on the same way. So ide madri now again. We have read 1 read panno. Ipa thirumbavum 0 read panrom. So different symbol has been read. Again, what you have to do? 0 ku badala X potittu right hand side nee move pananom. So again, you are reading Y. So again, you same symbol up. Again, you have to move to the next one. So the same thing has to be repeated. And finally, once you reach the last B, your machine will halt. Okay, so that is what is given here. Working on it in the same way, the machine will reach the state Q3 and head will be pointing to the B as shown there. So we will be reaching the last blank symbol B. Okay. So the next move will be, the transition will be from the Q3, the final state, taking the symbol B from the tape. What it does is it will halt. So what do you mean by halt? It just stops and it will accept the input string. Yes. So only when the pointer reaches the last B, last blank symbol, and the transition is the pointer, the state is in set of finite states, set of the final state. It can be Q Q3. So in our example, Q3 is the final state. Yes. So this string will be accepted by the Turing machine. Are you able to follow, ma? Yes. So just hold on 1 minute. I'll be back. Yes, ma, I'm back. Are you able to hear me? Shall we continue? Yes. So you have learned what is to be done with the Turing machine. Yes. So you have to draw the tape. You have to insert the input strings in the cells. Yes. And you have to show the transitions. And you have to state. You have to show how. We move from one state to the another, and how do we replace the input strings 0 with the X, and when you have to move left and when you have to move right, and when the machine stops, and whether at last you have to tell whether that input string is accepted by the Turing machine or not. Yes. So this is how you have to solve the Turing machine problems. Okay. Tape is the data structure what we use. Sometimes this question can be asked. So like how we use and stack for the pushdown automata, the same thing can be asked for the Turing machine. So what is the data structure that will be used for the Turing machine? So your answer should be an indefinite length tape. Okay. Okay, so what are the important notes you must remember whenever we talk about the Turing machine is, in non-deterministic Turing machine, there can be more than one possible move for a given state and tape symbol, but non-deterministic Turing machine does not add any power. Yes, similarly, every non-deterministic Turing machine can be converted to the deterministic Turing machine. So when we were discussing the pushdown automata questions, we had this question. You remember? Yes. So they have given some 4 options, like the non-deterministic pushdown automata can be converted to the deterministic pushdown automata. Non-deterministic finite automata can be converted to the deterministic finite automata. So they have given something like this. You should remember what can be converted to the other types and what cannot be converted. So that is also a very important question in the GATE class. Okay. So to confuse you, they will ask some. They will give you some 4 options like this, and they will ask you to pick one. Pick which one is the correct option or which one is the wrong options. So be thorough with those basics. Okay. So here, every non-deterministic Turing machine can be converted into the deterministic Turing machine. So this you must remember. Okay. In multi-tape Turing machine, there can be more than one tape. So as the name implies, so these are all the types of the Turing machine. So you will have a deterministic, you will have a non-deterministic, you will have a multi-tape. So all these are the types of the Turing machine. Okay. So in multi-tape Turing machine, there can be more than one tape and the corresponding head pointers. Okay. But it does not add any power to the Turing machine. Okay. Same like our first one. Okay. And the last one is, every multi-tape Turing machine can be converted to a single-tape Turing machine also. So you should remember the types and what can be converted. Every non-deterministic Turing machine can be converted to the deterministic Turing machine, and every multi-tape Turing machine can be converted into a single tape with single pointer. And so these are all the important notes you should remember for the Turing machine. Okay, so we have one more problem to be discussed. Yes, so you have to tell me what are the steps to be done. So what is given is a single tape Turing machine. So this is of a type where we'll be having only a single tape. Okay, this is not a multi-tape. So you'll have a single tape and you will have a single header. Okay, M. So the machine is named as M, has two states, Q0 and Q1. So they have clearly stated that the machine has only two states, of which Q0 is the starting state. Okay, then obviously Q1 should be the final state. Yes, the tape alphabet of M. So what are the sigma is given is 0, 1, the blank symbol represented by the B, and its input alphabet is 0, 1. The symbol B is the blank symbol used to indicate the end of an input string. Okay, so B indicates always like how we use hash or epsilon. We use the epsilon in the pushdown automata to represent the end of the input string. So similarly here, B is used to denote the end of the input string, and the transition M is described. Oh, fine. In the question itself, the transition table is also given. Q0 taking, so as told earlier, we have only two states, Q0 and Q1, but we have the input symbol 0, 1 and B. So B is given here. So Q0 taking 0, so it is a first input, so it goes to the next state in Q1. 0 is written as 1, so 0 is replaced with the symbol 1, and we move to the next symbol right side. Okay, so if Q0 takes 1, so already we are in the 1, so any number of 1, it remains in the same state, and whenever Q0 reaches B, it halts. Yes, similarly Q1, so Q1 taking 0, so what it does is it remains in the same state Q1, and it is replaced with 1, and it goes to the next step, because you are reading the same number of 1, so it moves right side. Yes. So similarly, Q1 taking the blank symbol, what it does is it again moves back to the Q0. Yes, ma? Looks like something went wrong. Students, are you able to hear me? Yes, okay. Some network connectivity problem. Okay. The table is interpreted as illustrated below. So what they say is the entry Q1, 1, R in row Q0 and column 1 signifies that if M is in stage Q0 and reads 1 on the current tape square, then it writes 1 on the same tape square and moves its tape header one position to the right, and the transition to the state Q1. So this one, the usual one, what we already know. Yes. So Q0 taking an input, replaced with another symbol, and it moves, the pointer will be moving to the right hand side to read the next input from the tape. Yes, the same is what given in. So let us concentrate on the question, what is being asked. Which of the following statement is true about the M? So what this Turing machine does, and just look at all the options it is asking for, when this machine will halt and when does the machine does not halt. Yes, the very simple options are option of 3 and 4. We will just start with options 3 and 4 first, and then we'll go for the options 1 and 2. Okay, so option 3 and 4 states that M halts, stops, which is nothing but stops on all the string ending in a 0, and M halts on all the strings ending in a 1. Okay, so let us first design the machine that ends with the 0 and check whether this option is working or not. Yes. Okay, let us go for the solution. So let us see whether the machine halts on the string 1. So initially state will be Q0 and the head will be pointing to 1 as shown in this figure. So let us consider that the string ends with 1. So So initially the figure looks like this. Yes. So what it does after reading this one, yes, it just moves to the next state. Yes, considering that it has read any number of ones or zeros, whatever it is. So Q naught, it after reading the one, it will move to the state Q1 and the head will move to the right hand side, which means it is pointing to the blank. Yes or no? So blank is being pointed now. Yes. So now again, what will happen is now we are in the state Q1 and the input symbol is B. So whenever it is B, what you have to do is you have to again move back to the initial state Q0. Yes. So initial state is Q0. We have reached to the Q0 and the input symbol what is written in the tape is B. Again, you have to move it to the left. Yes. So just look at the transition, you will understand. So the transition of Q1 comma reading the character B is it moves back to the initial state Q0 and you have to replace B with the B and you have to move to the left side. The pointer has to be moved to the left hand side. Yes, which means it again comes back to the 1. So it will move to the state Q0 and the head will move to left and it will be pointing to the 1 again. Okay. So this keeps running again and again and again and again and it will never halt. Okay. So that is what is given here. It will run in the same way again and again and not halt. It will never stop at all. Yes. So option D says that machine M, the Turing machine M, halt on all the strings ending with 1. But just now we saw from the diagrams that the strings ending with 1 is never halting at all. It keeps repeating again and again. Yes. So this option D is not correct. Yes. So I think obviously the same will be applied for any string that ends with 0. Okay, let us have a look at that also. Okay, so let us see whether the machine halts on the string 0. So initially the state will be Q0 and the head will be pointing to 1 as shown in this figure. Okay, so just have a look at this. A Q0 taking 0, so what it does is it moves to the next state Q1 and 0 will be replaced with the 1 and it moves to the right hand side. So right hand side the symbol in the tape is B. Yes. So Q0 lambda Q1 ku poyaachu 0 nradha it has been replaced, substituted with the character with the letter 1 and we have the tape has moved the pointer to the next letter in the tape, which is moved right side. Okay, that is denoted here. Okay, now what happens? Q1, we are in the state Q1 and the input symbol is B. So what it does, whenever B is read, blank symbol is read, the pointer the control transfers again back to the initial state Q0 and now it pointer will again move back to the left. So which means again it is pointing to the input symbol 1. Okay, so same process repeats now. So it will run in the same way again and again and does not halt. So option C says that M halt on, M is nothing but the Turing machine denoted by the letter M, halts on all the string ending with the 0. But in our case, just now we discussed that it is never halting, it is never stopping and the process keeps repeating. So option C is also incorrect. So now we have to check with either option A or B. Yes. Okay. Option B says that the machine M does not halt for any string 00 or 1 star. Yes. But you should be, we know that the null is a part of this language. Yes. And the Turing machine will halt for null string. That also we know from the note point what we have learned. Yes. So for the null string, the tape will be looking like this, which means all the cells will be filled with the B because we don't have any input symbol. Yes. So for this input, for sure, my Turing machine will halt. Yes. Okay. So using the transition Q0, B, it automatically goes to the halt. So the Turing machine will surely halt. Yes, as Turing machine is halting for null, this option is also incorrect. So So obviously option A is correct. Okay, I'm just checking the options. Yes, just check this options. Okay, so third option is not true because they have denoted that M does not halt. So that is not the case. So with the given expression 00 plus 1 star, null is a part of this string which will make the Turing machine to halt. Okay, but they have given that M does not halt. So that is not the option. So option B is incorrect. And options C and D. So we have discussed with a diagram also that M does not halt for the string ending in 0, and M does not halt for all the strings ending with the 1 also. Yes, but they have given that M halts. So B, C, D, all the three options are wrong. So obviously option A is the correct answer. Okay, ma'am. Okay, so whenever it is Turing machine, so Turing machine starts with the T. So you should remember you have to draw a tape. So tape also starts with the T. So this is how I used to remember some shortcuts. Okay, fine. So we'll go to the next problem. So these things we discuss now. Turing machine for addition. So interesting one. So I told you in the beginning of the class itself. So Turing machine can be used for addition, subtraction, multiplication, and arithmetic operations. Yes. Okay. So a number is represented in binary format in different finite automata. Like 5, how do we represent in the 8421 code? We represented a 5 with 101. Yes. But in the case of Turing machine addition, so either we use all zeros or all ones. So this is how we represent the number. Okay, so in our example, the 5 will be represented with the sequence of 5 zeros or 5 ones. Suppose if the input number is 10, so we represent 10 zeros or 10 ones. If it is 7, we represent 7 zeros or 7 ones. Yes, so this is the technique we follow for the Turing machine. Okay, so for our convenience in this upcoming examples, we'll be using the zeros for representation. Okay, so whenever you have two numbers to be added, in between the two numbers, we use an intermediate C to split the inputs. Okay, so for adding two numbers using a Turing machine, both these numbers are given as input to the Turing machine separated by a C. Okay, so just look at this example, you will understand. So 2 plus 3, if you want to add 2 plus 3 using the Turing machine, so you have to use the 2 is represented with two zeros, 3 is plus symbol is represented by the character C, and the 3 is represented by 3 zeros. So as I said earlier, you can either use full zeros or full ones. So for our convenience, we are using zeros. Okay. So input is 20 plus 3 and output will be 5 zeros. So the normal addition, what we all know. Similarly, one more example, 4 plus 3. So we use 4 zeros. Plus is represented by C here, and 3 is represented by 3 zeros. So the output will be 7, which is represented by 7 zeros. Yes? Okay. So what is the approach we use to solve this problem using the Turing machine is convert the zeros in the first number into the X. So as we have discussed in the previous examples, yes? Whenever you encounter 0, you replace it with another character X. And then you traverse either input, entire input, and convert the first blank encountered into 0. So whenever first blank comes, you have to change it into 0. So 0 are the X mathu, blank are the 0 mathu. Okay. Now what you have to do is then you move towards the left. So blank ellathi ignore panita, C A U ignore panita, you start moving to the left hand side. Okay. So come to the position just next to the X and then repeat the same procedure till the time we get a C instead of X on returning. Okay, so first right la ellathiyum 0 ellathiyum 1 a maatittu eppa space varudho appa 0 va maatittu you start moving towards the left. Okay, finally you convert the C into the blank and the addition is completed. Avladha ultra bulta da left la move panna C varudhu space varudhuna stop panna appothula undu right la move panna. Once you have encountered the C, you just stop it and finally you are done and the addition is completed. Okay, so this is the approach we use, and the steps are what I have told you now is given as an steps. Okay, so just look at the diagram. So from so you will have an one finite step. So Q naught taking zero. Either you replace it with you replace the zero with the x, and we move to the right. So any number of zeros, it remains in the same state. And whenever a C is encountered, it moves to the next state, Q2. Yes, and again, any number of zeros you encounter, you remain in the same state. And whenever you encounter one or blank, what you do is you move to the left hand side. So the same process will be repeated again and again. And whenever if it is blank is red, then we reach the final state Q5. Yes. Okay. A Turing machine for subtraction. The same concept is applies here. So whatever it is, whether it is 3 minus 4 or 4 minus 3, the output is going to be 1. Yes, and you will get the 1 0 as an output. So suppose it is 7 minus 4 or 4 minus 3. So the output will be 3. So where your output you will get is 3 zeros is what you will be getting. Yes. So similarly, so this is a transition diagram. So totally you will have 8 states. Yes, so you should have a keen look at this one. I'll share this document with you. Slowly you work it out. So only when you take the problem, you analyze, you ask a question to yourself. So we are in the state Q2. So Q2 taking 0 or 1, where it goes next. Whether the pointer has to move left hand side or it has to move to the right hand side. So what is the tape symbol? Have we reached the blank or not? So you have to keep questioning yourself, and you have to check whether we have reached the final state or not, whether this input is accepted by the Turing machine or not. So question yourself and try to draw the transitions and make the states like this. So easily you will be able to solve the problems more faster. Yes. So only when you solve more problems, just by looking at the questions, you will be able to tell whether the Turing machine stops or whether it accepts the input string or not. Yes? Okay. So we have few more questions to be discussed also. Which of the following can accept even the palindrome over the alphabets A, comma B? Yes. So, so many problems we already discussed with the palindrome. So, if the input WWR is what we call it as a palindrome. Yes. So, we have two types that also we discussed. We have an even palindrome and odd palindrome. Yes. So, what is the question is, which of the following can accept the even palindrome over the A, comma B? So, we have already discussed this. A language generating the strings which are palindrome is not regular. So that cannot be represented using a finite automata. So obviously the option is non-deterministic finite automata. So NDFA is the answer. So NDFA can accept the even palindrome. Okay. So the pushdown automata, it can accept only the odd palindrome. So the question is even palindrome. So for which the answer is non-deterministic finite automata. Okay, ma? Okay, which of the following is false with respect to possible outcomes of executing a Turing machine over an input string? Okay, the question is which of the following is false? Okay, first one is it may halt and accept the input. Yes, if it is halt, it may halt. Okay, that is fine. It may halt and it can accept the input. Okay, good. It may halt by changing the input, so that is not possible at all. Yes, it may halt and reject the input, of course, that is possible. It may never halt. Yes, we have seen a problem where it keeps on looping. Yes, so the second one is the false statement. It halts by changing the input, so that is the wrong option. Context sensitive language can be recognized by the linear bounded automata. So this we already discussed in the last class. Okay. So two statements are given and they are asking which option is correct. There exists no algorithm for deciding if any two Turing machine accept the same language. Of course, yes. So there is no proper algorithm till now. So statement one is correct. The problem of determining whether a Turing machine calls on any input is undesirable, of course. Yes, statement 2 is also correct. Yes, so both statement S1 and S2 are correct. So what is the question asked? Which of the following options are correct? Both S1 and S2 are correct, of course. So you don't want to read the other options at all, since both these statements, given statements, are correct about the Turing machine. Which of the following is wrong? Okay, Turing machine is a simple mathematical model, not at all. And it is mainly used for general purpose computer. No, not at all. It is used for solving the complicated problem. First statement is wrong. Turing machine is more powerful than the finite automata. No, so finite automata is also more equally powerful than the Turing machine. Turing machine can be simulated by a general purpose computer. No, not possible. So all the given statements are wrong. Yes, so the option is D. A pushdown automata behaves like a Turing machine when the number of auxiliary memory is same. When the number of auxiliary memory is dash. Okay. Pushdown automata behaves like a Turing machine when the number of auxiliary memory is 2 or more. When you have more than, when you have more than one auxiliary memory, this is nothing but stack. So in pushdown automata, we'll be using the stack of our auxiliary memory or storage. Yes, but in Turing machine, when you have more than one auxiliary memory, then we call it as a Turing machine, where we convert it into a single take. Which of the following pairs have different expressive power? Expressive powers, whenever it is expressed different, you should have a multi-tape Turing machine and multi-dimensional Turing machine. Yes. Question is, which of the following pairs have a different expressive power? So it is very simple and it is very direct. Multi-tape Turing machine and multi-dimensional Turing machine. Okay, so this one you have to solve. Given a Turing machine is given initial state, final state, set of states, everything is given. The language accepted by the Turing machine is given as, so you have to work it on it, you have to draw the transition with which you will be able to find out. So it is going to be A, B and Q2. From Q2 again it is going to right side. It is going to be the third option. Okay. A, B, A star, B. Yes, ma? Okay. The Turing machine composite. So how do we represent? What is the expression for the Turing machine composite? We don't leave space between the two, which is nothing but T1, T2. So this is how we represent the Turing machine composite. Okay. A Turing machine that is able to simulate other Turing machine is universal Turing machine. Yes, if a Turing machine is able to simulate the another Turing machine, so this is nothing but an universal Turing machine. Okay. Which of the problems are unsolvable? So this is very important one. Halting problem, of course. Boolean satisfiability problem. So both are unsolvable problems till now. Okay, so Alan Turing proved in 1936 that a general algorithm to solve the halting problems for all the possible program input paths cannot exist. The answer is option C. Both halting problem and a Boolean satisfiability problems are unsolvable. Which of the following a Turing machine does not consist of? Input tape, head, state register, none of the mentioned. Okay, the question is does not consist. So actually, Turing machine consists of all these things. Okay, so the option is D. A value of N, if Turing machine is defined using the N tuple. So this is what we have discussed in the definition itself. So a Turing machine is represented with the 7 tuples. Yes, so explanation is given here. You will have a Q, S, G, D, Q naught, B and F. So a Turing machine, apdinave, you should have 7 tuples. So answer is option D. If D is not defined on the current state under the current tape symbol, then the machine very simple it has. It is not defined. அப்படின்னாவே obviously the Turing machine will halt. Statements, one statement is given, they are asking whether it is true or false. Instantaneous description can be designed for a Turing machine. Of course, yes. So, in order to describe formally what a Turing machine does, we need to develop a notation for configurations or the instantaneous descriptions, what we call it as an ID. Yes. So, it is true. The statement what they have given is true. You need an instantaneous description for whenever we design the Turing machine. Which of the following are the models equivalent to the Turing machine? So we have a multi-tape Turing machine, we have multi-track Turing machine, register machine. So all of these are the models that are equivalent to the Turing machine. So answer is all of the mentioned. Yes, okay. So we have reached the, we have completed all the TOZ important gate question topics. So I'll share all the materials. If you have any doubts or if you want more problems to be solved, just ping me or mail me. I have already shared my mail ID and my WhatsApp number. So any queries, any time you can ask me. So all the best to students. Okay. Shall we end the session? Okay, ma. Okay, fine. Thank you all. Bye.